Hey guys, how's it going? It's Brandon from Arubixs. Sorry it's been so long since we've released our last backer video, but you know, we've actually created a couple of backer videos and we've had to cancel them just because of all the things that have changed. And one of the really important things that I wanted to kind of discuss was some of the things I discussed in the last backer video, which was about, backer reimbursement and some of the big deals that we were moving forward with. And actually a lot of those deals did not end up developing. And one of them was with a major carrier, which I was going to say that I was going to announce to everybody who it was, but I may not be able to because we're doing another deal, which is actually very good news, with another Fortune 50 company. And I don't really want to say anything just yet because it may interact with that deal as well. But we were working with a major carrier, which we were doing an NRE deal where they were going to pay us to develop the phone to where we could get to the next step, to where we could start, you know, making large numbers, and we would take some of those funds to give to our backers just to reimburse them because they've been so patient with us over this time to get the phone developed. And another deal that was actually really big that we were doing was with a overseas distributor, and that was a 50,000 unit purchase order that we were going to do, which was a $30 million deal, and it also ended up not happening, which is unfortunate, but that's just the name of the game in what we do. And as I've mentioned before, you know, it's very difficult for a company of this magnitude, as far as the innovation and the development that is involved, to do something like this without a lot of capital. So it's very difficult for us. It's a very expensive project, and we only raised $47,000, and with Indiegogo's amount taken out, it was really like $41,000 needed toward a multi-million dollar project. So it's been kind of difficult. The reason why I've mentioned again is why we took that is because we knew that we could build better prototypes and be able to travel and get around to be able to raise more money to get into the phone ultimately is actually what we did. So we're doing a deal right now with a computer company, and it's getting pretty close to the end that we're wrapping up, and it's a similar kind of deal with the carrier. So I think it should be really good for us, and hopefully I'll have an update about that in the next video. So as far as development goes, we really haven't done a lot of different changes to the smartphone or the design or a lot of development on the forefront of maybe the user interface, things like that. So we haven't been able to really film a lot of content. We haven't been doing testing, and a lot of that is mostly just contingent to funding and budgeting and things like that. But in regards to funding and budgeting, one of the things that I have been doing lately personally is I've been going around trying to fundraise, you know, debt financing or banks or these pitch events, speaking with other investors, which a lot are usually private, but some of them that I have been going to recently, which we could roll some B-roll footage of me right now at some of these events. And it's a great place to meet other investors and to also carry out the brand of Arubixs and kind of making the investor community aware that we're out there and we're growing. And so yeah, it's been very difficult for us because there's a lot of hardware companies right now that haven't been doing very well in the landscape in Silicon Valley for raising funds in hardware is very difficult. And one of the differences between us and a lot of other hardware out there is we're in telecom. So we're kind of in the big leagues, so to speak, this is an important technology that's proven. Yes, the market is saturated. However, what we're doing is very unique, and I think a lot of you would especially agree that the industry is evolving and it needs something like us. So that's kind of just a quick snapshot of what we've been up to. Not a lot of development, but we have been spending a lot of efforts to try to fundraise and continue bringing in the capital that is needed to get to the next step. And one thing I'd like to talk about that is sort of relevant to development is one of the technologies that we were working on. I honestly really don't know where we kind of came up with it, but one thing that we thought would be really cool would to basically be a satellite communication with our phone, to where that our phone actually is able to send frequencies to a low Earth orbit satellite, where current cell phone technology uses cell towers. And it's sort of an outdated technology because of the fact that cellular signals are sent over the cell towers, which is a horizontal wave plane. So the signal actually goes along the surface of the Earth, and it's actually sometimes obstructed by anomalies like geography, buildings, trees, etc. So a lot of us experience dropped calls or very poor cell phone service, and that is exactly why that is. And if we were able to be able to communicate via satellites, and we had a satellite grid that was communicating with cell phones, you would have a much better signal all the time. And we thought that would be something very innovative that we could try to play around and experiment with. So we built a satellite, and this is the satellite that we've been working on. We've been testing it when we can get lab time in the anechoic chambers to test the antennas and some of the equipment on it. It's been pretty interesting, and one of the things that one of our advisors had advised us to do would be to start a separate company because the technology is so different. And initially, personally, I thought, wow, cool, another company, that'd be a great idea. But then again, going into hardware, it's very difficult. But we personally believe that it's an innovation that really needs to be out there. And I think, you know, with the current position of the cell phone market and telecom, that it could be a lucrative thing. So that's pretty cool. One thing that we've been working on, we're going to be teaming up with a couple of major companies with that, and be doing a pretty big event that I might even share with all you, that I think that you could be interested, because it is sort of similar to what we do with Arubixs, and it's also very interesting. And one of the last most important things that I wanted to discuss was another effort for us to try to bring in revenue to keep this project going. And one of them was to do pre-sales. We get a lot of email. I think so far we have pretty close to 19,000 purchase inquiries from people emailing us, asking how they can buy the phone, signing up for basically the release for when we do the first pre-sales. And we thought of doing something a little bit different, but similar to those lines, but also very disruptive. And one of the things that we've been kind of tossing around was doing pre-sales. And the way that it works when we build our prototypes, we get a certain number. So we get a really small amount, and it's a very high cost. And one of the things that we were thinking about doing is taking a small amount of those prototypes, and those would be considered about like beta prototypes, maybe MVP, not quite pre-production. We would take maybe five, maybe six of those, and we would sell them at a very, very extremely high price, like $300,000, which you might think is incredibly crazy, and it sort of is. But there is two, you know, things of importance to doing that, and one of them would be that it's disruptive. It's a crazy price, and we think when we notify everyone that they might kind of be a little upset. And the fact that they're upset, they're gonna talk about it, and press is gonna bash it, and they're gonna say a lot of bad things, it's crazy, whatever they're gonna say. But that is going to drive a lot of traffic back toward us, interest into the phone, and of course, brand awareness through multiple channels. The other important factor of that is to generate a lot of revenue. And with that amount of money, if we could sell four, five, six of them, it would actually take us to the next step where we could have prototypes, those prototypes that we could then submit to carriers for carrier testing. Most carriers, just quick side note, will not even talk to you unless you have a pre-production prototype that they can test in their network and in their marketing. And it's a very extensive, long process. So getting us to that next step is also better with investors, with banks. We can get purchase orders, things like that. So that's important for us. And it's actually not uncommon. It's very simple model that is very similar to the Tesla model, which is build low volume, high cost, and then scale to high volume, low cost, which is something that's quite common with a lot of companies, brands. So that is one of the things that we are thinking about doing, and we're thinking about launching maybe around sometime February and taking on pre-sales. So I wanted to run that by everyone and not try to let everybody know that, hey, they're gonna sell phones, you know, before they take care of the backers. That's not true, because in this way, we're kind of doing this to help the backers. Because we only have a very small amount, and I think we have like 142 backers, and we don't have the capacity to do that at all, unless we had millions and millions of dollars. So pre-selling like 5 exclusive phones to some very, you know, privileged people would be a way for us to get money back into the company, get us to the next step, maybe, you know, reimburse our backers, but most importantly, get us to the point where we can start doing high volume. So those are some of the updates. I've talked about some of the deals that we've been doing, a little bit about the development and the investment opportunities that we've been trying to reach, as well as some of the new projects that we've been working on, and most importantly, doing the pre-sale. So I hope you enjoyed that. Again, I'm really sorry for taking so long to get back to you guys. We just haven't had a ton of video content to show, and the videos that we did do just became irrelevant, and we didn't really want to put them out because we usually wait a little while before we upload them just to make sure everything's okay. So thank you again for being patient, and I look forward to the next video, and I hope you all are doing great. And remember that we're not done. This is not over, and we look forward to finishing this with you.